Setting up a VPN on a router can give all your devices a shield of protection against basically any type of online threat. But while it sounds great, it is not that easy to do. So here is how to install VPN on router in a step-by-step tutorial. Basically, the VPN tunnel hides your device's IP and encrypts all the data coming through the VPN server. I also use this setup for when I need to change a virtual location on devices that don't support VPNs, like my gaming console. However, not all VPNs support these setups. So if you want the best VPN for router, my personal recommendations are either NordVPN, ProtonVPN, or Surfshark. They've all proved to work reliably, and you can often get them at a discounted price. I will put a link to the best current deals in the description. However, keep in mind, not all routers support VPN, so you'll need to check if yours is compatible. You can just Google your router model plus the VPN name of your choice. You also need to check whether your router can only use OpenVPN or the newer and faster WireGuard as well, though the latter is still pretty rare. For this tutorial, I am going to teach you to set up NordVPN on Asus router using the OpenVPN protocol. That said, the OpenVPN on router setup is really similar among all three best VPN picks. After, I'm going to show you WireGuard router setup using ProtonVPN. Surfshark has this as an option too, but personally I found it to be easier with Proton. The first step is to log into the router control panel. For the Asus router, you can type this or this. If you have a different router, check your router manual for the default router IP. You should see login boxes to add a username and password. By default, both of these are normally admin. And if not, just check the bottom of your router for the actual password. Once you're in, select VPN on the left side and then choose the VPN Client tab. If you've updated your router, you might see VPN Fusion instead. In that case, your router most likely supports WireGuard too, so I'd suggest using the timestamps to go to the WireGuard part of this tutorial. Whatever the case, click Add Profile and in the pop-up window, select OpenVPN. In the description part, give the connection name, and if you see an option for auto reconnection, enable it. Now you'll need to download the OpenVPN client configuration files. To do this, you need to take a small detour, open a new tab, and go to the NordVPN website, then log into your Nord account. In the NordVPN tab, go down to Advanced Settings, and under the Manual Setup, click on Setup NordVPN Manually. Here, first select the Server Recommendation tab. You can choose your location here, and NordVPN will recommend the best server. If you want the best speeds, I don't recommend a VPN router setup with a server on the other side of the world. Choose a closer one. You can also select the server type, either a standard one, optimized for P2P, or one with privacy enhancements. But keep in mind, not all server types are available in all locations. Anyway, here you can download the configuration files. For OpenVPN, you'll see both UDP and TCP options. Generally, UDP is faster, so let's go for that. Here, also click to get the service credentials and copy them. Then go back to your router settings, input your copied credentials in the username and password fields. After, click Choose File and open the file you just downloaded. Then tap Upload. Wait until you see the complete message and click OK. Now, if you go to the VPN Client tab, you should see the created connection. You can activate it to start using NordVPN on router. And just to be sure, I always run a check on ipleak.net to see if the VPN is truly active. Whenever you want to stop or turn on the connection again, each time you'll need to go to the router VPN setting right here. In case you have a router that supports a WireGuard connection, you want a VPN that can give that to you. And here's a VPN setup on router step by step with ProtonVPN. The first step of learning how to put a VPN on your router is the same as with OpenVPN. Open your router page by typing its local IP into your browser and then log in using the default credentials from the bottom of your router, or your own ones if you've changed them before. Underneath Advanced Settings, choose VPN, then the VPN Fusion tab, and click to add profile. Here, select the VPN type as WireGuard. Then we need the configuration files, so we're taking a detour into the ProtonVPN page. Here, log into your account, and in the download tab, go to WireGuard configuration. Pick a name for it, and then select router as the platform. Here you can customize level of NetShield blocker filtering, whether you want ProtonVPN to not interfere, to block malware, or to get rid of ads and trackers as well. Moderate NAT is a specialized thing for gamers, while port forwarding is for avid torrenters. Most of us don't need them, so you can skip it, but turn the VPN accelerator on. It's going to give you better connection speeds. Proton is automatically going to suggest the best server for you, but you can also select one from the list below, and then click Create to get the configuration file and download it. Now we can get back to the router settings. Here, click the Import Config File button. Locate the WireGuard configuration file you downloaded, open it, and you should see all the fields autofill. Once you click Apply and Enable, a VPN connection should be established right away. To turn it off or to turn it on later, you can toggle the switch next to the new connection in the VPN Fusion tab. And again, you can check if the connection works using the ipleak.net website. And now you know how to set up a VPN server on your home router. Yeah, it's not as straightforward as just using a VPN app, but it's also not rocket science. It just requires slightly more effort. I hope this how to install VPN on router guide was clear. For any setup troubles, keep in mind that my suggested VPNs all have guides and knowledgeable customer support, so reach out to them if you're stuck. Of course, you can ask me in the comments as well. And if you don't have a VPN yet, use the links in the description to grab one at a discount. Cheers.